Hello everyone, this is Testing Tear. Well, actually, this is the account of Testing Tear. This whole video, the voice, the review, is all by ImBlenderDude, which is me. Testing Tear was actually kind enough and trusting enough to actually lend me his account so I can do this review. That's very trusting of him. I respect him for that, because he has been guests already. Do stuff with Blender, modeling, animating. I admit I suck right now. But I suggest coming back in like a few months or maybe a few years or so, when I actually have some sort of skill to brag about. But if you want to see me progress throughout the years, then feel free to do that as well. Do special effects as well with Blender. Yeah, it is possible. Look, it's me. Anyway. What I'm going to be doing today is actually showing you each and every game recorder I've come across, I've tried, I've used, and I've been searching for a while. I'm going to do a personal review about each and every one of them, since I actually have tried, I believe, all of them that are out there. If I didn't include one, then feel free to go ahead and tell me. But anyway, we've got so much to cover that this will have to be a two-parter video. There's that much out there, really. So go to part two if you want to see the free game recorders and maybe some bonus recorders if I have enough time. Right now I'm going to be showing you the ones you have to pay for, which with trials and limitations. So to start out with, which I literally have to start out with, I can't not include it, is Fraps. Now, Fraps is by no means free. It's like $37 last time I checked. You can record the sound, record the microphone as well if you have that plugged in, which is always fun to do. It's very straightforward. Choose what how many FPS you want, or just add your own in. What resolution you want. That's pretty much all there is to the game recording part. The free trial of Fraps, so the limitations are, the free trial records up to 30 seconds, and it has a watermark, which actually machinima users do use Fraps. They just like record a certain angle for 30 seconds, crop out the watermark, and just video edit it all together. That's usually how, it's usually what they do. It actually works quite well for them. A big downside to Fraps for me and a bunch of people, there's like a third to a half of the population that don't really like it that much. And that's because of how much quality and how much it tries not to lag your game. It really doesn't compress the video, I think, by any. So you have like huge file sizes. Like I tried recording gameplay. It was big. I know Justin Tay personally tried 4.5 minutes of recording at 30 FPS, 320 by 240 resolution, and that whole video ended up being like over 2.5 gigabytes. I don't know about you, but I do not have that much space on my computer. I know Testing Tay has had problems with Fraps in the past as well, because next reason I'm about to show you, which is a lot of people also don't like Fraps because it tends to be an FPS hog. This is Testing Tay's video of this game. You can see how much problem he's had with it. It's 240 resolution. 30 seconds is it, 71 megabytes. That's a huge file size for such a small recording, small resolution. And that as far as speed goes, that's ridiculous. I'm going to put it down completely, though. I will say it does come with excellent quality in both sound and video, and it attaches itself to a huge variety of games. I believe they're all full screen, though. If it's not a full screen game, or if it doesn't reach past 640 by 480 resolution, you can probably count on Fraps not to record it. No, there are some exceptions to that, as well as some exceptions to what it can record. Don't know what they are, I'm not going to get into those right now. Instead, I'm going to go to the next game recorder, which would be Wegame. I know what you're thinking, wait, isn't Wegame free? Well, it was. Often referred to as the free Fraps, Wegame was once free. This is the interface. One of the downsides to it is that you have to make an account just to actually do anything with it. I don't see why they do that. And Wegame's really only half free right now. I say that because you cannot do a full screen recording. If you do that, it says it's a VIP only feature. You say okay, and it'll take you to its site asking you to buy it. I don't personally like Wegame. I know when I tried it, the sound really tended to get out of sync. Which, it does record sound, and the free version, its only limitation is that it reduces your resolution to half size. It will record up to 30 FPS down to 15. It's not a CPU intensive of Fraps. Notice that the quality isn't really all that good. It may just be the fact that half-size recording is enabled. I don't know. I don't know what codec it uses or anything. But if it floats your boat or whatever, then hey, feel free to use it. But it's just personally not for me. Again, it doesn't have a watermark, doesn't limit how long you record. Its only limits for the free one is that you'll be reduced to half size. It really isn't that much to think about. On to the next one, by order of popularity, GameCam, both V2 and Xpress. They both have similar limits as far as they can't record sound. Excuse me. Sorry. But anyway, GameCam Xpress doesn't limit how long you record. However, it does limit the size of your recording, the resolution, by 4. You'll be stuck with resolution that's cut down 4 times. Quadruple size. That's really, really low. If you want a decent size, then you're going to have to record in complete full resolution that your game can handle. And it'll also have a watermark in the bottom right corner. It's really a bit of watermark. But big pro to this is that it uses the DivX codec, so it comes in clear quality. I have had personally no lag with it at all. I had to actually be told it was recording, because I didn't know it runs that smoothly. And also, because of the DivX codec, it actually has a very good file size. I've been trying to find those right settings for DivX, which I actually suggest downloading the DivX codec so you can use that. The GameCam V2 limitations doesn't limit the resolution of your recording. However, your recording amount limit, how long, is limited to 45, which is 15 seconds more than Fraps. Power a machinima recorder or maker. I would personally choose GameCam V2 over Fraps, if not just because of the file size, but it also has no lag, and I can get up to 45 seconds, and I would just deal with the watermark that it has. And somehow, I think I would replace the audio with my own effects, or just use Audacity to record sound and sync up the video later. But anyway, if the GameCam is very good, it attaches itself to games, I think kind of like Fraps does. Not so much Wegame. It attaches itself to more than Wegame. It attaches more to the popular games, kind of like Wegame. So you can't record like Mugen, which is a downside to me, because I like sometimes to record my Mugen just to review what strategies I have. I know Testing Tear, he has his own Mugen channel called TheDarkEvilKen. He does some awesome videos. Subscribe to him there. Feel free to drop him a request. I know I will, sooner or later. As soon as I can think of a good challenge for him. Yeah, he's a good player. Anyway, so far I would choose GameCam over the other recorders I've showed you. So on to the next one, we have PlayClaw. Now PlayClaw, the only limitations for the free one is that it has a watermark which will bounce around the screen. It's a fairly small watermark, and it's fairly easy to ignore. That's the only limit. It doesn't limit anything else, the resolution. It will record sound. It doesn't limit how long. So yeah, PlayClaw is actually pretty good. And I've noticed that it really doesn't lag quite so much compared to some other recorders I have. It comes out with a clear quality. As soon as it starts up, here we go. You can actually choose whether or not to apply compression. That's good, because that means how big a file size you get and how much lag you have. Full size, half size, resolution. The frame rate will go up to 60, down to 15. That's actually pretty good. You can choose to capture the cursor, which is good if you're like doing walkthroughs on stuff. It will pre-record max buffer size, no idea what that is. It will record the audio and the microphone. You simply enable that. It has a lot more options than Fraps. It's a very good program. And so far, PlayClaw ranks in the top out of the ones which I have showed you so far. Oh yeah, another cool thing about it, you can actually select what interface language you want. That's cool for people who like have difficulty with English or something. People from not here. So yeah, PlayClaw is actually pretty good. I would use it myself. But again, it won't attach itself to everything. I still can't record my Mugen with it. So, on to the next one. Dxtory. Now, Dxtory has a few more limitations than some others. For example, every time you start it up, it makes you wait 10 seconds before you're able to do anything, which is more annoying than a limit. Also, it has a huge watermark while you're recording. Well, not while you're recording, but in the video. Really, really big watermark, very hard to ignore. But apart from that, it doesn't limit how long, doesn't limit the resolution. You can actually manually put the percentage of resolution you want, which is also very cool. Scaling, percent, size. The frame rate will go up to 120, down to 10. You can actually choose different codecs, and that's very, very useful. Especially if you want to like choose a different codec for reasons of size or lag or quality. Though the codec it comes with is actually a very good codec. It is clear, however, it does produce big file sizes, so I personally would have to change it to like the DivX codec. PlayClaw also comes with its own codec as well as Fraps. You can select them, but you can't record with them and make the game crash or the recorder crash or nothing will happen at all. Anyway, it can actually record sound from the speakers and up to 8 different audio streams, so you can set it up to record the microphone as well, which is always fun for those people doing, like, they actually record their reactions to the game while they're playing it.
What's going on here? Oh no! Something's happened to the Master Emerald!
Gee, thanks, Captain Obvious. I would never have guessed.
Who are you? Did you do this? Oh, I'll get you for
Falcon
this!
Falcon Punch! Boom.
Oh.
Ow. Ow. Oh. Huh. Nasty fall.
Hey! No fair!
Never it. Don't know why people like that. I know I sometimes like to do it. It's kind of fun, I don't know why. Anyway, it attaches itself to games a lot like Fraps does. Has a lot more options than Fraps. You can actually choose where the FPS counter is, and whether or not to just disable it completely. That's also very cool. Has a lot of options, most options I've seen. And final limit to it is that every time you close it, it'll open up your web browser immediately, asking you to buy the thing. That is highly annoying. But hey, if it works for you, then woohoo! Now, with 1 minute left, the final recorder, ZDSoft. ZDSoft is actually a very highly unique program, for reasons I'll get into in a bit. I may have to stretch this out over part 2, I apologize for that, but anyway. Like everyone I've showed you so far, you can just pick it up and go for the most part, but do not choose the codec that it comes with, which is X264VFW, blah 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 blah. It's not really good codec unless you can like configure it to make it good, and good for you, I just personally choose the DivX codec, since the one it came with was bad quality, got out of sync a lot, didn't record much. I noticed for me, I think it actually lowered its own priority or settings, just so that I wouldn't lose any frames per second while recording. It's the end of part one.